Lauck appear important in the eyes of his lady friend, Penelope Prittle. So Squire Kemp has hired a Professor Kabotsky, a genealogist, to trace Lum's ancestry. Yesterday, Lum received a chart showing that he is related to a certain Hempstead family. And he also received an envelope which is not to be opened except in the presence of all the Hempstead heirs. Just a moment, we'll see what the old fellow's up to today.
And now let's see what's going on down in Pine Ridge.
Worrying about it, Abner. We'll open it quick as we find all the Hempstead heirs. You just sat there looking at that envelope till you just let your curiosity run clean away with you.
Lom, I don't care nothing about opening it if I just know what was on the inside of it.
Well, how are you going to find out what's in it if you don't open it?
I don't know. That's the trouble. Don't reckon we could just raise that flap just a little bit and just sort of glance in there and see what's here?
No.
I don't see how that hurt anything.
And I don't see what you're worrying about. It's my envelope, or part mine anyway. And it ain't supposed to be open till all the Hempstead heirs are present.
Well, Lom, we wouldn't take nothing out of it.
No, we wouldn't take nothing out of it.
I don't see how it'd hurt for us to just take a little look.
Well, it wouldn't hurt. Now, just hash up and quit tempting me.
Hey, you reckon it's got gold bonds in it?
No, I don't hardly think there'd be gold bonds in it.
No, ain't heavy enough for gold bonds, I reckon. More likely a deed to a lot of property.
Or a map to one of the Spanish treasury chests, maybe.
Oh, Lom, you got your fingernail underneath the flap there, and I just one good hiccup, and you'll flip it open accidental. Ain't nobody looking, Lom. We could shut it right back up again.
Oh, yeah, we could close it right back up. No, I don't think it'd be right, Abner. No, don't much believe we ought to do it. What do you think about it?
Well, I don't see no harm in it.
You don't, huh?
Long as we don't bother nothing, no.
Well, of course, I don't like to set up and argue with you. I say not to open it, and you say go ahead.
Yeah.
Looks to me like your judgment ought to be as good as mine.
Why, sure.
Well, argue with me some more.
Well, now, Lom, just put your fingernail back underneath there.
But, Abner, if we was to get caught doing this, no telling what they'll do to us.
Who is it that catch us? Who is it you're feared of?
Yeah, that's right, ain't it?
Professor Kabotsky, that genealogist, discovered the envelope in a bank over at Portsmouth, and he sent it to Squire to give to you.
Yeah, I reckon I got as much right as anybody else.
Why, sure, old buddy.
More, the way I look at it.
Amen.
Let me see just exactly what that writing on the envelope does say.
Yeah, read it again, Lauck.
To be opened on the 151st anniversary of the Louisiana Purchase, April 1803. That's this very month?
That's right.
But only in the presence of all my rightful heirs. And it's signed Christopher Hempstead. He don't say in case of or nothing there, does he?
No. Of course, though, he ain't here long.
No, but I don't know, Abner. I've got a strange feeling about it. I don't believe in haints or nothing like that, but I don't know. It just sort of gives me the flibberty gibbet.
Hand it here. I'll open it. I ain't flibberty.
Well, it'd be just as bad for you as it would for me.
Well, you don't think you ought to do it, Lom.
No, go ahead. I reckon it's all right. Just don't never mention it to a soul.
Oh, I would.
Now, shake hands on that now.
Okay. How'd it do?
We'll just take a real quick look and close it back up right fast.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, what you waiting on?
I feel like somebody's watching us.
Watching
us? Yeah. Feel like it's a pair of eyes staring me right in the back of the neck.
Yeah. Grin as I do, too. Don't move, Abner.
You see anybody?
I ain't turned around.
Well, look and see.
I can't. My head won't turn. Be quiet.
Here's my knife. Just slide it under the flap.
Don't give it to me. I don't want it.
Well, I don't want it. I was just joshing. I was just making out like I was going to open this envelope.
For sure. I knowed you were.
Oh, no, yes.
Yeah, if I'd have had any ideas you'd have opened it, I never would have let you even look at it. Hooray! I say hook. Ain't nobody back there. Ain't nobody standing back there staring at you.
Did you look over back at the counter?
No, you better look back there to be sure.
No, you go, Lom. I'll stay here and watch the handbell. No, wait, we'll both go.
Yeah. Come on.
Yeah.
Don't turn loose on my hand.
Oh!
Goodness sakes, I can't run and you... I don't want to be dragging you all over... wait.
See somebody?
No, I told you there weren't nobody in here. Heidi, you a grown man, scared of ghosts. Scared to walk across the store and draw it open daylight for yourself.
Oh, I weren't afeard.
Well, turn loose on me then. Get your hands off of me.
Well, don't bust it that way. Doggy, you break every finger on it. Ooh-wee. Doggy, that was a close call. I'd have swore somebody was staying right then.
Get your imagination working, I reckon. If you hadn't gotten scared, we'd have not had that envelope open by this time.
Wish now I'd have went ahead and opened it up, regardless of who was watching. Where are you going, Lom? You going out, Summers?
No, I'm just going to prop the door open a little.
Well, what for, Lom? If
you think I'm just propping this door open because I'm feared of haints or ghosts or something and fixing it so as I can get out in a hurry, you're wrong. Just a little warm in here is all.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Leave, I'll just move my chair up closer to the door there, too. Get a little breeze. That'll make it cooler. Don't you want to get your chair and bring it up there too long?
No, I think I'll stand up for a while. My legs get cramped sitting down so much. Well, why don't you just run your knife blade under the envelope flap now and sort of lift it up, Abner?
I believe we ought to wait another day or so. Maybe you'll hear from that ad you put in the county seat paper.
Well, I put that ad in yesterday, though. If there's any kinfolks of Christopher Hempstead around, they ought to have saw it by now.
You never put the ad in until yesterday afternoon, though, and that wouldn't be in until today's paper. It ain't out yet.
Yeah, that's right, Aunt. Granny's not like to know what's in that envelope, though.
Oh, that thing's got me mesmerized. I never slept a wink last night studying about it, just wondering what was in it.
The way I look at it, there might be something inside there that'd give us some ideas how to go about getting in touch with any of the other relays, if there is any.
Yeah, sure.
Fact is, that's the only reason I'd even consider opening the thing.
Well, that's nice of you, Lon. Think of others like that.
Well, you know, I ain't got a selfish bone in my whole head.
Oh, I know that. You're always respecting the rights of other folks, I'll say that first.
Yeah, and I believe there's something in that envelope that'd give us a clue where to find any of the Hempstead heirs. It's my bounden duty to open it up and find out.
That's the time. Does my heart good to hear you talk like that. You are the unselfishest one human I've ever known, I do believe.
Well, thank you. I've always put my relays ahead of myself, I will say that.
Bless your heart. Bless your little heart.
And I sure don't want to keep none of my kinfolks from getting what rightfully belongs to them. I'd hate myself if I ever done that. Of
course you would. I wouldn't blame you none, neither.
Abner, I believe if the ghost of my great ancestor, Christopher Hempstead, was standing right behind me right this minute, he'd say, Lum, open that envelope.
That's exactly what he'd say.
Because he'd want me to be sure in my own heart that I'd have tried every way there is to find out if there's any more Hempstead.
Yes.
Christopher Hempstead was a fine man.
Oh, he was a fine fella. I'm fella.
Personal, I'm sure there ain't no more Hempsteads left besides me, but it's my duty to leave no stone unturned and no envelope unopened. Give me your knife, Abner, and I'll just slip it under the flap there.
Hello.
Oh, for goodness sake.
Ulysses!
Granny, you scared the daylights out of me, Ulysses. Where in the world did you come from?
You must have slipped up when we weren't looking. You see, Lom was just fixed to find out if there's any more Hempsteads, and, well, this envelope here is...
You don't have to explain to Ulysses, Abner.
Lom's trying to find the rest of the Hempsteads.
Abner, it's just a family matter, Ulysses.
That's okay.
Lom just loves and admires the Hempsteads.
Abner.
Yeah, that's okay of you, Lom. Because, well, I believe all us Hempsteads are to stick together.
Yeah, of course we... Us? Hempsteads?
Well, blood is thicker than water, and it looks like the plot is thickening, too. Just a minute, we'll come back to Lum and Abner.
Listen to these knockout specials for tonight.
Now, Ulysses, just sit down and tell us how you figure you're one of the Hempsteads.
Okay.
Go ahead, Ulysses.
Yeah, go ahead, Ulysses. Begin right at the beginning and tell us the whole story.
Just let him tell it, Abner. You ain't been over to Fort Smith lately, have you, Ulysses?
Well, you
been talking to Squire Skint, Ulysses?
Abner, quit interrupting him. Can't you see you're getting him off the subject? Now, begin all over again, Ulysses.
Okay.
And that's a good start. Now go right ahead.
Well, I was eating dinner.
Abner, for goodness sake. Now, you was going good there, and you had to butt in. Hurry up, Ulysses. We ain't got much more time.
Okay.
I'm afraid we ain't haven't got no more time here, Lacey. Just tell the folks so long for now.
Okay. Well.
Never mind, I'll do it. So long, folks, and so long for Ulysses, too.
Yeah, so long. See you tomorrow.
Okay.
Tune in again tomorrow night at 5:30 for another visit with Lum and Abner, brought to you by Abel's Auto Company.